In the course of investigating the DVNF, we uncovered yet another charity that asks you to help veterans by opening your wallet, but then uses only a very small percentage of it to actually help veterans. This is a completely different group. They call themselves the National Veterans Foundation, but there is a connection to the DVNF. Turns out they both use the same fundraising company. And in both cases, that's where the trail of your money seems to lead. Drew Griffin's on the trail.
Meeting the needs of veterans and their families.
The 27-year-old National Veterans Foundation would like you to believe it takes your money and puts it right back into its unique program, a national hotline to help veterans with anything. But CNN's investigation has found something the NVF likely doesn't want you to know. Most of your contributions went to pay the private fundraisers they hired.
Charity Watch gives the National Veterans Foundation an F grade. They're only spending 12% on charitable programs, and it's costing them $91 to raise $100.
Daniel Borikoff runs a nonprofit charity watchdog group that grades charities based on those charities' own tax filings. And those filings show over the past 3 years, the NVF has taken in $22.3 million in donations and paid out $18.2 million to its fundraisers, Brick Mill, and the parent company, Quadriga Art. But Borikoff says the filings also show a common tactic used by charities. Part of the money paid Brick Mill and Quadriga Art was designated in tax filings to pay for educational, awareness, promotional materials. Those solicitations for donations that tell you all about the struggles vets have and why you should donate, that's the educational, awareness, and promotion material.
The accounting is somewhat confusing to the public, and so they can get tricked if they look at these tax forms or look at these superficial reviews of charities on the internet, because what they're doing is they're calling that solicitation that makes you aware of the injured veteran a charitable program. But that's not what people want to pay for. People want to pay to offer substantial aid or assistance to injured veterans, and that's not what's happening in this group.
The National Veterans Foundation hotline is run out of a fourth-floor office in this building near Los Angeles' International Airport. The group told us they wouldn't speak on camera. We decided to go and see them anyway.
Hey, Rich.
Hello, you're Drew?
Yeah. Hi. Just wanted to ask you one more time if we can chat.
As we said, we've told you we've made our statements we've given you, and we're not going to be doing anything on camera.
So you won't tell me what you told me on the phone, on camera, that you're disappointed in this Brick Mill and Quadriga?
I believe if you read our statements, it will cover everything that I've said and anything that you were, any questions you have.
Well, it didn't. That's why I'm here. Can we take some...
We prefer not on this subject.
Rich Rudnick is the operations director for NVF and, over the phone, told us the charity hired Brick Mill and Quadriga Art in 2008 to start a new donations campaign. We were told for 2 years it would be very expensive. Then we'd be going into the black. That never happened, Rudnick told us over the phone. But in person, neither Rudnick nor its president, Shad Mashad, a man paid $121,000 a year, would tell us anything.
Can we take some photos of the guys just answering the phone? This is where the toll-free line is.
Yeah, this is the toll-free line, but they are busy right now, and we prefer not to this on this trip.
Okay. All right. Well, listen, thanks a lot. And Shad, he's not around?
Never here in the mornings.
Shortly after the door closed on our camera, CNN received this statement from the National Veterans Foundation saying, knowing what NVF knows now, it would not have entered into a 6-year contract with Quadriga Art and Brick Mill. The National Veterans Foundation says it's now trying to terminate that contract, which doesn't end for another 2 years. What does Quadriga Art say? Well, it did just what it was supposed to do, increasing the charity's donor base by 700,000 people. But even Quadriga Art admitted to CNN the fundraising efforts did not prove as financially viable as the client had hoped. Quadriga Art says it, too, now wants to end the contract. And despite Brick Mill and his parent company, Quadriga Art, getting paid more than $18 million, Quadriga Art says it actually lost money. Daniel Borikoff says baloney.
We really have to ask, why is this going on? What's the point? Who's benefiting here other than the fundraising company?
Drew Griffin joins me now. Also, Ken Berger, the president and CEO of Charity Navigator, Charity Watchdog Group. I got to say, I just find this unbelievable. And Drew, I mean, I applaud your reporting on this because this is outrageous. If people knew that these organizations, first of all, that first organization has not sent any money directly to disabled veterans. And this one, how much did that guy say? 81 cents on the dollar goes to the fundraising organization?
That's absolutely right. And that's what is heartbreaking here, because behind all these donations are Americans who really want to help these veterans. That's why this is so disheartening. They're opening up their wallets, thinking they are doing good, and putting money directly into the hands of a for-profit company that's making a killing off of this.
And you go to that office, they have an American flag there, they have a POW MIA flag. I mean, if they really care about veterans, they should shut that organization down. If they're not happy with this contract that they stupidly signed with this fundraising company, shut it down. I mean, how do they sleep at night? I know you can't answer that question, but that's what I would like to know. How do these people sleep at night? The kinds of contracts, Drew, signed by NVF and in the other instance, Disabled National Veterans Foundation, they're long. It seems like they're hard to break. So why did they go down that road? Is it simply to expand their mailing list?
Here's what we found out in our reporting. Some of Quadriga Art and Brick Mills contracts with really big charitable organizations are specifically detailed with money amounts included, all kind of contract obligations that both sides have to meet, very specific. These contracts with these two groups that we're talking about, they're rather loose, not too much specific. It seems like Quadriga Art is driving the legal paperwork here, and these charities are simply, I don't want to put words in their mouth, but they look to me like they've been duped.